Okay, guys, so we're back for our follow-up video on section 4.2, slope. Okay, the slope of a line, the slope, the rise over the run. The difference of my y's divided by the difference of my x's. Okay. Filming this on Sunday the 24th of October, almost Halloween time, almost the end of the quarter. End of the quarter comes Friday. End of the quarter is Friday. So I'm not exactly sure how your grade will be calculated. I just started this weekend, so I'm sure that'll be a question for Mr. Rich, okay? But please don't panic. If you're willing to work, we'll try to help you figure things out, okay? That's what our job is. So, this will probably be one of the shorter follow-up videos because there's not that many ideas that we want to look at, but we do want to look at some word problems. I do want to look at the idea of parallel lines and perpendicular lines. And then that'll take us through the end of this video. And then that'll be sections 4.1 and 4.2, and you'll probably have some type of evaluation come Friday. So let's look at some of the tougher problems in this section. So this is going to be another one of those describe and correct. Describe and correct the error. So I'm going to put the problem up here. You have it in your book. It's on page 154, number 19. Again, these show higher order thinking skills. It shows you have a better understanding of the topic if you can answer these types of questions. So they have a picture on that. I'll do my best to recreate. They have a point here, that's 2, 3. And they have a point over here, that's 4, 1. And they say that the slope is 1. So I would like you guys to take a look at that, see what you think, see if you agree with that. And if you don't agree with that, which you shouldn't, because I'm telling you there's a mistake, when you look at that, you're going to try to pick out what the mistake is and do it correctly. So again, let's do our favorite thing here. Pause the video and give that a shot. Okay, we're back. We want to see what the mistake was. Well, let's try to find the slope here. First of all, when I look at this line, if I look at a line between those two, that line looks to me like it falls. So in my mind, it would make sense that my slope should be negative, not positive. So let's see. Let's see if that's what's happening here. So I do 1. Well, let's do this over here. 4, 1. Okay, and then 2, 3. So let's make this x1, y1, x2, y2. 3 minus 1 over 2 minus 4. Uh-oh. 2 divided by a negative 2. That's a negative 1. They said the slope was 1. There's a mistake. They said the slope was 1 when in reality, it was a negative 1. Okay, and you probably could tell by looking at the picture. That's my hope. My hope is that you could tell by looking at the picture. Okay? So let's look at a couple word problems. Okay, let's say we've got a house here. Here's your roof. This is part of your roof. Okay, and let's say that this is part of your roof, okay? And let's just say that from here to here is 4 feet, and from here to here is 12 feet. Don't know if I really drew that to scale. Let me try to do a better job of that. That's four, and that's 12. That might be a better idea. Okay, if you're looking at a house, you're looking at just part of the house, and you get some windows here and stuff, and you get some windows over here in the other part of the house. But so if we said this was 4 feet and this was 12 feet, I wanted to see if you can find the slope of that roof. What's the slope of the roof? Pause. Pause that video. Okay. So what am I doing here? First of all, if I'm looking at the slope of this roof, I know it's going to be a positive slope because it rises as you look at it from left to right. And how much did I go up? I went up 4 and I went over, I went up 4 and then over 12. So my slope would be 4/12 for 1/3. What do you think? Now we have this. Use an equation to find the value of K. To find the value of K. And so they say 1/3 is one of your points, and 5K is the other point. And they tell you the M is 2, the slope is 2. So what I'm going to do here is I am going to write an equation for my slope. So again, my slope is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So my y2 here is k, so I'd say k minus 3 over 5 minus 1, and that has to equal 2. Okay, well, let's take a look. There's a little bit more that we can do with this. So my k minus 3 would stay. K minus 3 divided by 4 equals 2. So let's say I wanted to get rid of that 4. Okay? And so if I want to get rid of the 4, I'm going to multiply by 4 on both sides. And I'm going to get k minus 3 equals 2 times 4 is 8. And then I'm going to add 3 and add 3, and I get k equals 11. Okay? That's how you do it. That's how you do it. Let's see what you can do with this. Negative 2 and k, and then 2 and 0. And they want M to be -1. So please, 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 please pause that video and see what you can do. Okay, I think I've given you some time for that. X1, Y1, X2, Y2. So I'm gonna do 0 minus K. 0 minus K over 2 minus a negative 2 is equal to a negative 1. So, I'm gonna have 0 minus k over 2 minus negative 2 becomes 2 plus 2, which is 4, equals negative 1. Okay, now I'm gonna multiply by 4 on both sides. And so when I do that, the 4 is canceled, 0 minus k is just a negative k equals negative 4. I don't want to know what, negative k is. I want to know what k is. So k equals 4. Hope that's what you got. Okay? So the last two things that I want to look at here is the idea of slopes of parallel lines and slopes of perpendicular lines. It's a good song right here. I'll let you guys listen for a little bit. It's one of her best. Did it have the popularity of some of her other songs? Although, if you asked me, I'd put this right near the top of the list. Okay, so slopes of parallel lines. Here's what you have to know. Parallel lines have the same slope. And that kind of makes sense if you think of it. You had a line like this and a line like this that are parallel. It kind of makes sense, doesn't it? They have the same slope. They have a different starting point, but the amount they go up and go over would be the same. To me, that makes sense when I look at it, okay? And so what they're gonna do here, now sometimes the equation might look like this. Y equals 1/2 x minus 1. Y equals 1/2 x plus 3. You can tell that those two are parallel because the slopes are the same. Okay? The m here is a half. And the m here is a half. So therefore, those two things have to be the same. Now there are other times when they give you a graph, okay? And they say that, let's see. Negative 4, negative 2, and this point here is gonna be negative 3, 2. Okay? And then this one here is 1, 3. And then we have 0, negative 2. 0, negative 2. Forgive my drawings. And this one here is 4, 1. And this is 3, negative 3. Now my drawings are not to scale. Okay, I'm not going to pretend they are. 3, negative 3. Okay? So what we're doing here is we want to know if any of these lines are parallel. And you're going to say, well, look at the drawings. They can't be parallel. I'm telling you, you can't go by the drawings because I did a lousy job with the drawings. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to find the slopes. So there's three slopes that we need to find here. Okay, let's call this one number one. Let's call this one number two. Let's call this one number three. We want to know if any of these lines are parallel. Okay, so please pause the video and find those slopes and tell me if you think any of them are parallel. And I'll go over the answer shortly. Okay, so for this one, I would do negative 2 minus 2 over negative 4 minus a negative 3. So it looks like I got negative 4 over negative 1. So that one, my slope is 4. Next one, I'll do this one here. Negative 2 minus 3 over 0 minus 1. So that's negative 1 over negative 1. M is 1. Well, those two don't have the same slope, do they? Oh, hold on, I made a mistake here. Negative 2 minus 3, that's actually a negative 5. My mistake. So that's going to be, slope is going to be 5. All right. And then the last one, negative 3 minus 1 over 3 minus 4. So that's going to be negative 4 over negative 1. M is 4. So these are parallel. Okay, make sense? All right. Last one we're going to look at. My last video of the weekend. I've been filming videos all weekend. Be a nice break for me. A chance to go watch some football, see how my fantasy team's doing. Last I checked, I've got 4 of them. 1 I don't really care about, and then 3 that I kind of care about. And I was losing in 1, and I was winning in the other 2. So we'll see what happens after these videos are done. I'm still in the 4 o'clock hour. It's about 3:15. This is the best time of the week, so I do want to see that. So, slopes of perpendicular lines. You guys know what perpendicular lines are? Perpendicular lines are lines that cross and make a right angle. Okay, they make a 90 degree angle. That's what a perpendicular line is. Okay, and we can tell when slopes are perpendicular because the slopes of, let's say this, the product of slopes of perpendicular lines are equal to a negative 1. So if you take 2 slopes and you multiply them together, and that product is equal to a negative 1, then those lines are perpendicular. So if I had 2/3 and I multiplied by negative 3/2, well, let's look and see what we get. 2 times negative 3 is a negative 6. 3 times 2 is a 6. That's their product is a negative 1, therefore those lines are perpendicular. Okay? They're perpendicular. How many people have said that in this song? We are never, ever getting back. They always do, don't they? Don't they? Especially when they're like your age. They say, I'm never going to be back with them again. Next week, that's what you see. Don't say it if you don't mean it. Okay? Don't say it if you don't mean it. So, I'm going to give you guys a couple of lines. Okay? So, we are going to draw... Okay, and I'm going to call this point over here negative 5, 6. And this point over here is going to be 1, 4. And that's going to be a line. Okay. And then this line, that's going to be 0, 5, that point. And then this point over here is going to be negative 2, negative 2. And then I'm going to have another line that goes through like this. And this line has negative 5, 0 as a point and 2, negative 2 as a point. Okay? So I've got 3 lines. I'm going to call this one line 1 and this one line 2 and this one line 3, just so it's easier for us to refer to. Okay? I'm going to pause this quickly.